Hello students, now continuation of that human reproductive system. That last class we discussed about that what are the organs or tissues, organ systems are derived in that germinal layers, as well as what is the development of this one. Suppose if they ask, for example, whether you remembered or not, suppose dentin, which particular it will be present from mesodermal, suppose enamel, that is ectodermal. So within the same, that comparative one, once or twice, once one can go through and all. Then one can continuation of a developmental and all, of completion of gestation period, then the baby ready to deliver. That is what we call the process of delivery of that fetus is called as parturition. After parturition, then lactating milk and all. That is now in related to human reproductive system, that is the parturition, that is the process of delivery of the fetus is called as parturition. In this parturition, so after completion of the development of that baby, either male or female baby, which one can release some reflexes and all, that is we called as fetal ejection reflex and all. Then fetal ejection reflexes. So after complete maturation, after complete maturation of baby, which one can release some reflections and all, that is fetal ejection reflexes. These were which one can stimulate posterior lobe of pituitary gland. That posterior lobe of pituitary gland, which one can release is oxytocin hormone. Then OT, oxytocin hormone. Oxytocin hormone may causes labor pains. It causes labor pains. That means delivery of that particular, before delivery, which one can ready to take some particular that changes one can take place in that mother womb and all. That is regarded as in that induces labor pains and all. These labor pains, it will be persisted. It is depends upon that particular parent and all, several hours it will be present, that labor pains and all. Then it may be leads, then it will be continuation. These labor pains may induces, that is involuntary contractions of uterus and all. It may be involuntary contractions of uterus due to continuous involuntary contractions of uterus and all may causes dilation of that particular cervix and all. Then it may be continuation like dilation of cervix. If it is continuously takes place, then dilation means which one can relax it, which one can increase this size. Whenever increased, whenever relaxed, then ready to whatever fluid present inside that one, apart from that particular fetus, which one can ready to eject, which one can ready to deliver and all. In this one, in this dilation, apart from this oxytocin, apart from this one, that particular luteinizing hormone, already we studied, that is chorionic gonadotropin, which one can secrete by the particular placenta, human chorionic gonadotropin and all. It is equivalent to the, that is luteinizing hormone, which one can maintain corpus luteum, that which one can secrete maximum amount of progesterone, one can secrete maximum amount of mucus on the cervix, which one can act as a plug to prevent that particular abortion of the baby and all until completion of gestation. Once again, after completion, which again that relaxin hormone, which are secreted by the corpus luteum as well as the particular placenta and all, relaxin. So one among the hormone, oxytocin. The second one related to relaxin secreted by the corpus luteum as well as placenta and all, which one can induce that particular relaxation of that pubic bones, that particular connective tissue of that particular bones and all, that is the pubic symphysis and all. So this relaxin hormone, one can induce that particular relaxation of this pubic symphysis and all. Along with this one, some of the ligaments, it is also easy flexible. It may induces that to flexible of ligaments of that is sacral as well as sacrococcygeal, sacral as well as sacrococcygeal ligaments, sacrococcygeal joints, or which one can present that ligaments and all, which are present in that that pubic symphysis region, which one can related to relaxation, which one can flexible, that means ready to opening in that cervical one. It may leads to the maximum dilation of cervix and all. It may be also causes to the maximum dilation of the cervix. It is also leads that dilation of cervix. Then ready to deliver of the particular baby. So in this labor pains, what are the stages which one can observe? There are three stages observable: the stage of dilation, the stage of expulsion, that is the placental stage and all. The first one, in labor pains, there are three stages are present. The first stage we call as stage of dilation. In that stage of dilation, because of that particular oxytocin as well as relaxation, these particular hormones and all, which one can flexibility of that particular uterus, that continuous, that particular contraction of the uterus wall. Apart from this, that is that contraction of uterus wall only we call as labor pain and all. In this one, due to continuation of that involuntary the movements of uterus and all, then automatically it may leads to the dilation of the cervix and all. So because of oxytocin as well as relaxing hormones, it will leads to the dilation of cervix. Whenever cervical dilation, then automatically which one can increase that the cervical part of that female reproductive tract and all, then amniotic cavity which one can rupture. Here amniotic cavity or amniotic sac, it will be ruptured and all. Inside the amniotic cavity, amniotic fluid is present, it will be ruptured and all. Then that amniotic fluid which one can flow along with the vagina, then amniotic fluid that flowing that throat vagina, from cervix to vagina, which one can, normally it will be present minimum 6 to 12 hours one. It is, if it is average one, some rare cases and all, minimum 2, maximum 20 hours also present. Averagely 6 to 12 hours. This is dilation and all. Then that stage of expulsion, due to that particular complete dilation of cervix, due to the complete dilation of cervix, then automatically the baby, which one can, it will be coming out that cervix and vagina and ready to deliver and all. Then that delivered that baby and all. Due to expulsion, that expulsion is after completion of this amniotic fluid and all, then along with this one, the baby also, which one can coming out first, head will can be comes out. Suppose instead of head, once one can come related to legs and it is difficult to birth and all, that is we called as breech, that delivery and all. It is very difficult that normally one can heads. That's why lying down, that particular baby at the age of that 7th month and all. Then in that third one related to that placental, that placental stage, suppose if it is last for minimum 100 minutes, then up to hours, up to few hours it will be present, this expulsion and all. After removing of that particular vagina, that particular amniotic fluid throughout that vagina, then baby it will be coming out. That is regarded as delivery, that birth of that particular baby and all. Then after birth, that is regarded as placental stage and all. In that placental stage, because of further that particular, these particular contractions and all, it will be present to 10 to that 15 minutes. It will be present due to the forcible contraction of uterus. Then automatically, which one can peel off, which one can separate it, there is a placenta along with certain parts of that fetus as well as uterus, it will be coming. Due to forcible contraction, placenta, it will be coming out along with that baby and all. Then due to contraction, the constriction of blood vessels. So here, due to contraction, that constriction of blood vessels which are present in uterus center, that's why which one can reduce the loss of hemorrhage at the time of delivery, some amount of blood acid will be coming out because of constriction, because of reduced the blood vessels, destruction of blood vessels and all, which one can maximum reduce and all these one related to natural delivery. Suppose artificial means, so surgically one can remove, that is separate and all, that is related to natural delivery and all. Then it will be present minimum within this one, the placenta, that fetal one, apart from this one, uterus one, everything and all. After completion of this delivery and all, 28 to 35 days, again it will be come to the normal part, normally which one can arrange that particular uterus wall and all. Again, ready to start that particular, which one can present in normal position. So how many days after delivery, which one can come to the normal position of that particular uterus wall and all, then your answer will be the 28 to 35 days, which one can come to the normal position. Normal position of uterus, why? Because decidua, certain adjustment of uterus, already we said decidua and all. This decidua after removal, after completion of the birth, then again one can come minimum 1 month time, it will be takes place and all. Then after delivery, what is the particular stage, what is the particular changes one can take place, that is regarded as lactation. Lactation, normally mammary glands which one can ready to start with the help of estrogen, progesterone at the age of the puberty and all. Then after delivery, because of that particular prolactin hormone, because of prolactin hormone, because of the prolactin hormone, which one can synthesize as well as storing of the milk in mammary glands and all. It helps synthesis and storage of milk in mammary glands and all. Then prolactin normally secreted by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland. Then oxytocin. Oxytocin helpful ejection. So after delivery, then only it will take place. Oxytocin, it helpful ejection of milk. Then when it will be start, when it will be begins the production of this milk and all, immediately after delivery of the baby, within 24 hours it is ready to start and all. The first 2 to 3 days, that particular milk, that is the yellowish color, that type of that milk we called as colostrum. This colostrum, it will be contain certain type of the proteins under lactalbumin. It will be contain lactalbumin as well as lactoproteins. Apart from this one, it is also present one important immunoglobulin. It will be present. It acts as very crucial role for passive immunity of that particular baby. That is immunoglobulin A, it will be present. Then less amount of fat, everything present. That milk, it is vital role for more immunity of that particular baby and all. Then after 2 to 3 days, immediate after delivery, that colostrum yellowish color, which one can be present and all. yellowish color of this one. Then normal milk and all, after this one, the mother's milk, it will be contain maximum amount of water. So it is only close from within 2 to 3 days. Then afterwards, it will be present maximum water as well as inorganic constituents like the calcium, like sodium, like phosphorus, like potassium, such type of inorganic constituent, as well as organic like sugars, that means lactose and milk sugar. Then apart from this one, protein, this is lactose and protein, it will be present like casein protein. So colostrum, what type of protein present in colostrum? That is the lactalbumin. What type of protein present after colostrum? That is the casein protein, it will be present. Then apart from these ones, some vitamins, very less amount of the vitamins like vitamin C, it will be present. Vitamin C also, it will be present. Then less amount of mineral, that is important. What type of less amount of mineral one can available? Iron, it will be present, little bit very less. So iron will be present in that less amount, it will be present. Along with this one, remaining all type of these, that is, milk is the wholesome food material. That's why breastfeeding, normally the doctors which one can suggest that particular infants and all, because of more immunity. It is also one among these one, that controlling of that birth. This controlling of this particular, the chain birth, which one can contraceptive, one among the methods. But it is not 100% reliable and all. Then, that is related to this one. Then, among this one, another very important one, recently one can identify one important role of hormone, which one can secreted by the placenta and all. That is CRH. So recently found the placenta, already said that last classes and all different types of hormones one can secret like HCG, HCS, like this one. Among this one, very important role, one can be takes place crucial role, that is the corticotropin releasing hormone. Once again, corticotropin releasing hormone and all. It acts as a clock of the birth. It represents clock of birth and all. That means more secretion, this corticotropic releasing hormone, which one can premature delivery and all. Less secretion, which one can due date, after due date, that means after completion of 10th month and all. It is before 7th month and all. It depends upon, that's why clock of the birth, which one can recently they identified corticotropic releasing hormone and all. Then what is the developmental disorders normally one can observe during this particular that growth and development of that babies and all, that developmental disorders and all. These developmental disorders, amnionitis, that means swelling of amniotic fluid, swelling of amniotic that cavity and all. Then abortion, then teratogeny, or then amnionitis, that means which one can swell in regarding related to when taking of that particular nutrient food material and all. Any one among these one infection, it will be causes amnionitis and all. Then abortion, that is lack of progesterone. That means deficiency of progesterone hormone may cause abortion, may not be attained that particular wall of uterus, which one can detach the wall of uterus and all. That is absence of progesterone. Then teratogeny, already last class also we said teratogeny means which one can harmful substances. At the time of pregnant time, that mother one can take any alkaloids, any type of drugs, any type of steroids, either alcohol, either tobacco products, then it may be causes fetal defects and all. It causes the pregnant mother, one can take teratogens, Teratogens means like alcohol, like tobacco, like drugs. Any one among these teratogens one can take, then abnormal development of the baby. That is one among the important teratogens, that is the thalidomide. That is thalidomide or thalidomide, which one can act as an important role in this drugs and the multiple defects of the baby and all. So at the time of pregnant, without taking alcohol, drugs, chemicals, all these one, then it may be causes that fetal abnormality syndrome. Then here in this particular human reproductive system, what you must concentrate on that gametogenesis. Then what is the ploidy and that gametogenesis and all. For example, spermatogonia, what is the ploidy? What is the primary spermatocyte? What type of cell division one can take place? Then how many functional gametes one can form in male? Or how many functional gametes present in female? What type of hormones one can influence and all? Then how many that number of primary follicles which one can be present at attaining of puberty age related to female and all. So these particular number, their ploidy, then how many that a particular polar bodies or which one can be formed related to gametogenesis, their particular action. Then apart from this one, menstrual cycle, you must be concentrate different stages, different days, different hormones. For example, what type of hormone one can act as important role for ovulation and all. Then they have given LH, FSH, as well as gen, many one can given. Then your answer will be the LH only. Which type of hormone? It is equivalent to the, that is related to gonadotropin releasing, that is gonadotropin releasing hormone, which one can stimulate that particular FSH as well as LH and all, that secreted by the hypothalamus and all. Then human chorionic gonadotropin, it is equivalent to luteinizing hormone. Then that particular gestation period, that particular germinal layers, what is that particular organs, organ systems which one can form and all. What one can, which particular time one can completely development of that particular baby and all. When it is called as a deciduia, what is the another name of hystera. So all these particular ones or twice one can go through in that important role one can take place and all.